tonight on my big show. It's Catherine Ryan's turn to play Centre Wall. I wake up Bradley Walsh in the Midnight Game Show. There's music from the sensational Beverly Knight. And who will be tonight's unexpected star of the show?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the big show. Please welcome your host, Michael McIntyre.
But first, it is now time for the unexpected star of the show! Okay. So, this is Alfie. Alfie is 24 years old, and he can often be seen busking on the streets of Westmorling. But singing isn't something that has come easily for Alfie. Alfie was diagnosed with cerebral palsy at the age of 5. Throughout his childhood, Alfie struggled with his breathing. So his mum, Lulu, who's here tonight, introduced Alfie to his singing teacher, Anthony, who is also here tonight. And Anthony became a huge part of Alfie's life, helping him to discover his true passion, which is to sing. So where are you guys, Lulu and Anthony? There they are, big round of applause. Hi, Lulu.
Hello.
Hi, Anthony. Welcome, exciting night for all
Thank
of us.
You.
Aside from singing, Alfie is a massive Chelsea fan and he loves playing football video games. Tonight, Alfie and his best friend Dean think that they're coming to a new video gaming centre that we have built right here in the back of the theatre. So they've just arrived. Let's see if we can see Alfie and his friend. Oh, yes, we can. So that is Alfie on the left and that is Dean on the right. Oh, he's got his Chelsea coat on. Lovely. So he's going to be taken through to a gaming pod, and that is actually here on the stage with us. And he's going to play FC 24 against me. I'm going to be here, and I'll be Spurs. He's going to be Chelsea. And as soon as he scores a goal, the wall will collapse, and we will give him the biggest surprise of his life. Sound like fun? Now, of course, if he doesn't score a goal, none of that will happen. I will hammer him 4-0 and we'll play centre wall. Okay, so we're going to go live to the room and I have Caroline on an earpiece. So, Caroline, if you can hear me, just shout, goal! Goal, 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 goal,
goal!
Okay, so welcome to Star Games.
Welcome to Star Games.
Thank you.
Can I just ask, what teams do you support?
Can I just ask, what team do you support?
Chelsea.
Who's your favourite player of all time for Chelsea?
Who's your favourite player, probably, like, of all time for Chelsea?
Drogba.
And Lampard, yeah.
Point to him and go, the Drog.
The Drog.
Your Chelsea goal scorer!
Now go, super, super friends.
Super, super friends.
Super, super friends.
Super, super friends.
Super Frankie Lampard.
Okay, hand them some controls.
So we've got some controls here. There you go. You're obviously familiar with those.
Not
So, out loud and on the controller, I want you to control a real player.
Okay.
Okay, it's going to come out of there. Okay.
So go on, control him to score a goal.
So did you control him to score?
Okay, go forwards. turn around. Left. Left. Turn around.
My pleasure.
Frank, when you can, just say, what's that in the corner?
What is, is that?
That's you.
Is that my ball?
Are those my stats?
They're my stats.
My ratings?
Real numbers for me.
You're having a laugh, right?
You're having a laugh.
Headers, 68.
Hang on. I don't mind these, but 68 heading.
Champions League final, Moscow, come on.
I actually scored a fair... I don't know how many goals I scored in the head.
Give the ball to Alfie.
Do me a favour, take that.
Let's check these headers.
Let's check these headers.
All right, just let it hit you in the face.
All right, I'll go straight back to you.
Oh! Vision, 83.
Okay. What's vision, 83? Okay, well, I want to prove my vision's better than 83. Yeah. See that ball there? Write a word for me, or whatever you want, and I'll tell you now, I'll show you my vision.
Really?
Yeah, we want to test him.
Give me a bit of a chance, Alfie.
So, Manchester United.
Is it Man U? Manchester.
Why did I write that?
Take a step closer. LA Galaxy.
Is that an LA Galaxy?
one more step. Borussia Mönchengladbach.
Borussia Mönchengladbach.
Get right up to it so your face is against it and then just scream Chelsea.
Chelsea!
All right. Okay. Frank, I've got to get back in here. Wait for the next guys.
Thank you.
Become a robot again.
Oh, thank you so much. Happy? Oh, Michael, that was amazing. Yeah.
That was brilliant.
Oh, my God. Thank you so much.
Okay. I'm going to get into character. I'm going to look like, basically, my teenage sons. What? What's the problem? What? What are you looking at? What? What's wrong with you? What's wrong? I told you I'm hungry. What's wrong? What's wrong? Get out of my room. I texted you already. I'm starving. What is wrong with you? I've only just gone on it. Now you made me die. Yeah, whatever. Okay. Now, hopefully this will work. As soon as he scores, go crazy. On your feet, let's give him the best surprise he's ever had, OK? But for now, super quiet.
Yeah, you're going to love it. Right, come on in. OK, come sit down here. Pop your headphones on, get your controller and everything. Like you said, there's someone called Nicky who's set up to play with you.
Yeah.
And we've got you set as Chelsea's own headphones. That's it.
Got it.
OK, they are comfy.
Mm-hmm.
Put your controller.
Yep,
okay,
perfect.
So Chelsea. Okay, enjoy the game.
Thank you.
Have fun.
Is that me?
Hello.
Yeah, good to meet you, yeah?
Yep, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Perfect.
I'm going to beat you, yeah?
No, man.
No.
Yeah! Expected star of tonight's show, Alfie!
Oh my God, Michael!
On the TV show!
Oh my God!
Alfie, calm down. Alfie, there's your mum over there. There's your singing teacher. We are all here to surprise you. You're not at a gaming centre.
Oh my God!
We're all here.
Frank Lampard.
And you met Frank Lampard. Wasn't that amazing?
That was amazing.
What did you think when you saw him?
Like, I love Chelsea. Like, in my club, and Frank's like one of my favourite players ever. So.
Did you think it was a bit crazy that he was standing behind the curtain?
It was unbelievable. I can't believe it. I was like, oh my God.
Well, he, like all of us, we've heard all about you, and that's why we set this whole thing up. You're not in a gaming centre. It would be quite a lavish gaming centre if every time you score a goal, we reveal 2,000 people who cheer. You're actually in a theatre called the Theatre Royal in Central London.
Oh, my God.
And we are recording my TV show, Michael McIntyre's Big Show. I believe you've seen it. Look, there's the Centaur box over there.
And you're not going to make me get my phone out, are you?
No. We're here because you love singing, don't you?
I just love to entertain people, and I like to see joy on people's faces when I sing. And I think for me, you can make a real big change when we put positive energy into the world. And I think that's what we should all be here to do tonight.
Right. Well, there is so much positive energy in this room, and it's all for you because this is your night. You're going to perform at the end of this show for us. We're going to take you backstage.
Yeah.
We're going to set up a whole performance for you. Yeah. You're going to sing your favourite song and to give you a special moment and for you to entertain us.
Thank you. Thank you, Michael. And thank you, everyone. And let's have an amazing evening together. Yes.
Incredible. And one more person wants to come and say hi and wish you good luck.
Oh my God!
I did. I'm so sorry.
Oh my God.
I'm so sorry about that.
You're a legend.
No problem.
Hero.
You're a hero.
Oh. This is my hero standing here, man.
Super Frank.
I'm absolutely honoured to be here and be with you. You're a special person. I know all your story. Thanks for all your support for Chelsea. And I look forward to hearing you sing.
It's amazing. Thank you, man. Thank
no
you.
Problem. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will see him performing later in the show. It's our unexpected star of tonight's show, Alfie! Next, ladies and gentlemen, who would like to play Centaur? In our central box this week. She is one of the funniest people on your televisions. Canada's loss is our gain. It is the fabulously funny Catherine Ryan! K-Row! Darling Catherine, welcome.
Hello, Mr. McIntyre.
Who's in the box with you, Kay Rye?
My eldest daughter, Violet.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Catherine's lovely daughter, Violet, with us tonight. Welcome. Yeah, nice to see you.
Nice to see you. I also have my best girlfriends. It's Jen and Fiona.
Jen and Fiona, welcome. Normally people are terrified coming on the show and handing over their phone, but I get a sense that you're quite relaxed about it.
I have a very live and let live attitude. If this is the game you want to play, I'm in.
Yeah, that's what we like, isn't it? She's all in. No anxiety here. I wanted to talk briefly about your husband.
Bobby.
Because I love the story. So basically, he was your childhood sweetheart.
He was. I was 16,
Yeah.
I know. He was my first love, the second dude I ever lost my virginity to.
What? What? Oh, no. Violet doesn't want to hear that.
I don't.
That's the worst thing to hear. No, no. Kids can't think of things like that. So, 16 years old.
Yes, and I loved him.
Now, how did that relationship break down?
He needed to focus on football, he said.
Okay, well, American football.
American football. Okay. And so he split up with me at the prom.
No way!
I know.
That's terrible.
It really hurt. 20 years later, I'm invited by the BBC to appear on Who Do You Think You Are and trace my ancestry. Don't panic, we're not related. You don't expect to hook up on that show.
No. So off you go where? You go back to Canada?
To Sarnia, and it's such a small town that Bobby walks into the pub, and we were married 9 months later.
Oh, my God, that is a beautiful story. So, it is time to hand over your phone. Place it into this velvet cushion, and we will lower it down. Let's do this. Here we go. Nasty. Oh, I am now in possession of Catherine Ryan's mobile phone. Oh, there we are, ladies and gentlemen. So who is this on the front?
That is Violet and me from when we were younger.
This is an old pic.
She sasses me now, so I like to look down at my phone and remember her the way she was.
So, what have we got here? What's Ruby?
It's like different...
Welcome, Catherine.
...beauty concierge services that you can get at home.
Oh, you order them on the app?
Yeah.
Oh, this is fun. Massage?
Yep.
Have you had a massage? Have you pressed that?
I have, yeah.
Nails? Tanning? Love a massage. Facial?
Love nails at
home. Eyes? Look, you can order men. That's exciting. Can I get two American footballers, please? So you press massage.
Yeah.
And then... Ooh. Miles. Oh, he's got 129 five-star reviews. And I have to say, when it comes to getting 129 five-star reviews from a masseuse, questions need to be asked. Have you had Miles? Has Miles been
there? Oh, I've had Miles. He does it.
So I've just pressed postcode, and is that...
That's your postcode here right now.
It just comes up with a local post. Oh, maybe it's not. Oh, we've got options. We've got options.
I would love to buy someone a massage tonight.
Okay. Let's do that. Now what happens?
And then whatever time you want, tonight.
Tonight, 9 p.m. Continue. All right. Is that it?
Scroll down a bit and you need to...
Book now.
...use my Apple Pay, which hopefully the details of that come up on everyone's television.
So that is booked. Yay! So Miles is on his way! Okay, what's this one? Oh, there I am. What's this one all about?
Facetune.
Facetune?
It is a photo editing app that we use to be more beautiful.
So can you make me more attractive?
You look gorgeous. Why don't you...
No, I don't look gorgeous. I'm always disappointed with that eye. I always feel like it's trying to fall off my face a bit.
If you scroll at the bottom to some of the preset filters, you'll notice the difference immediately. Oh.
Oh.
Ooh.
This is amazing. Black and white didn't really do it for anyone. What's that? What's that? That's an Asian person. It's so funny, I pressed Asian and it's exactly the same. If anything, I've become less Asian.
If you click on the highlighted photo and take a photo, that'll take a picture and then you can manipulate that photo, Michael.
Oh, God. Okay. So I'll look like that blonde woman.
There you are.
So, what do I do now? Enhance?
I would say enhance is a good start.
Oh,
and then you
God,
can slide.
I look like a dolly. I look like a...
Okay, so then refine. Click on refine. And yeah. Put your finger on the eye that you don't like and just pull it up.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah?
I've clearly overshot slightly. Hold on. This is me in 10 years. That's series 15 of The Big Show. That is amazing. Oh, no, my face is gone.
Try resize, Michael.
Resize? Honestly, for years, part of me has, like, slightly exaggerated the Asian thing, but this is now... total confirmation. I think I need to go on Who Do You Think You Are? You find me here in Shanghai. That's him.
So if you'd like to save...
That is hours of fun. We'll move on.
Mr. McIntyre, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Has your self-esteem gone up or down?
No, but I can tell you what will be going up, and that's my right eye in all future photos. Now let's get this text in. Okay, so now listen, Catherine, the text is fun. And it's a sort of comedian thing. Because I was thinking about what to send on your phone, and had some fun ideas, but then I thought about what... Well, something in my life that pops up is that sometimes you make jokes about people.
I do.
And you have to... tell those people about it. I don't know if this has happened before. So it's basically that kind of a text.
Sure.
So how would you start a text to somebody? Would you, hi, hiya?
I'm straight in.
Hey, we can go straight in.
Well, let's see, what's your straight in?
My straight in is, I've got a new stand-up routine about the first time we met and how weird you were. I use your name as the joke doesn't really work without it. I'm going on Graham Norton this week. And really want to tell it. Just checking you're okay with that? Question mark. Happy to pay you something.
I mean, my mom's gonna be confused.
That's the fun of it. Now, do you think this warrants anything at the end?
I might do a
an
cash
emoji.
Cash emoji.
Cash. Oh,
yeah.
I love that money.
You know yes. what I mean? If you're ending on happy to pay you something, get a money bag in that text.
Yeah, bag of cash. Okay, shall we send that text to everybody in Catherine's phone? That has gone! We will be finding out later on the show what replies Catherine gets, but one more time for the amazing Kay Rye. And of course, our lovely daughter Violet, too, and her friends. Yay! Thank you, Kay Rye. All right. Okay, it is now time to play the Midnight Game Show! Of course, is the only game where if you snooze...
Yeah.
Very good. So let's find out whose room I snuck into in the dead of night. He is a true national treasure. It's Bradley Walsh, ladies and gentlemen! Go on, brothers! Here he comes! I'm coming up, brothers. I'm coming to join you. Oh. So, Brenners.
Yeah, go ahead.
Let's take us back.
Oh, no.
So, you were filming
yeah.
in the city of...
Sheffield.
Sheffield.
We were filming Gladiators.
Mm.
And the night someone broke into my hotel room...
Correct.
I decided to go to sleep.
Yes.
Because the following day was our day off. And what no one realised is, yeah. I'd had two glasses of red wine, and I don't drink red wine normally, an antihistamine because of my hay fever.
Yeah.
And I decided, well, I'm going to have a really good sleep. I decided to take a herbal thingy. Like, not like, what's it called? Like a sleeping drop. Like a, which I never take, you understand.
Like a sleeping pill?
Yes. So if you'd had a hand grenade and let it off next to me, I wouldn't have heard you.
Because you were in, you were not going to wake up. We actually, we could have stood over you sleeping for a period of time. And Bradis, would you like to tell the viewers how you choose to sleep of an evening? What do you choose to wear?
Well, it was very warm, you understand. And I sleep naked.
Yeah.
So, thank you, madam.
All right. Well, Bradis, without further ado.
Oh, no.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us enjoy Bradley Walsh's Midnight Game Show!
Sleeping within the walls of this hotel is TV legend, national treasure, Bradley Walsh. He's on almost every show. He's on the other channel, probably right now. But he doesn't know he's going to be on this channel tonight. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's Bradley Walsh's Midnight Game Show. Barney is here. Hi, Barney. Hi, Barney. So you've been staying at this hotel with your dad?
I have, yeah.
Okay, is he a deep sleeper? What's going on?
Yeah, he's a pretty deep sleeper.
Okay.
We've been working hard, so he's going to be quite knackered. I can't lie to you, Michael, I think he's going to be pretty angry. He's just a bit grumpy and he's tired, to be honest with you.
I'm a bit more nervous than I thought I was going to be. I didn't think that that was going to be an issue.
It's fine, it's only Dad. Okay. We've got his room key here.
All right.
Best of luck, you're going to need it.
Thank you. Thank you for the key.
No worries.
Let's do it. All right, let's head up to his bedroom.
Oh, dear.
Feels like people are asleep here. Probably because it's 1 o'clock in the morning. We need to be quiet. I was hoping there'd be some room service left on the floor that I could have a nibble on. But no such luck on this occasion. It's 2:30. Right, here we go. Here we go. 2:38. All right, we're good.
This is your midnight game show, Bradley. We've got a lot of fun.
Oh, I've got any pants on.
Bradley, I'm going to ask you some questions before you fully wake up.
Oh, right, I was quite really out.
I'm going to ask you to name three famous Bradleys. Here we go. This is what we like.
Oh,
here
God.
We go. Including yourself.
Bradley Cooper.
Yes, that's correct.
Bradley Cooper, Bradley...
Including yourself.
Okay, me.
That's
Omar Bradley.
Omar Bradley?
Yeah, he's an American general in the Second World War.
That is excellent. You're on fire already. Okay, now, you are host of a very successful game show.
The Chase.
That's correct. Now, we are going to find out whether you yourself can beat a chaser.
Oh, no.
So please welcome Anne Hegarty, the governess, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. Now, I'm going to ask General Lawrence questions. If you get it right, Anne will stay there. If she gets the question you got wrong correct, she will take a step towards the bed.
Uh-oh.
If she gets three questions right, you'll lose, and she will be in bed with you. When I say you will lose, so will you, Anne, because Bradley's not wearing any clothes. So the first question to you, Bradley, is what year was Marmite invented?
Oh, 1872.
Oh, it's not far off. Do you know, Anne?
It's 1902.
I thought you'd come up with something that was wrong there, Anne. Please take a step further to the bed. The chase is on. What three ingredients go into the cocktail Boulevardier?
Boulevardier.
Boulevardier.
I would say Chambord.
Ooh.
Champagne.
Ooh.
And something else, lemon.
I can say that none of those are in it.
It's whiskey, vermouth, and Campari.
Oh. I'm sorry to have to say, please, you are now seated on the bed. Now, we are in a terrifying situation. Can you film that?
Oh, wait a minute, someone's got some pens.
Whoa, they've landed on... Okay.
We've got to get in the bed, in just a second.
In the state of Georgia...
Oh, hello.
What is it illegal to eat using a fork?
Soup.
That's a good answer. Anne?
It's fried chicken.
Get in bed. The chase is over. Anne Hegarty is the winner! Thank you, Anne Hegarty, ladies and gentlemen. Brilliant, Anne. What a brilliant sport.
Is that like chicken?
Chicken. You learn something every day.
What is that? What is the matter with them?
Now, the chase is an incredible success.
Yes, yes.
There's been a few moments which have brought a tear to your eye comedically.
Yes, yes.
So I'm going to ask you those questions again, and can you remember the actual answers?
OK, OK.
Question number one. Dump, floater and wipe. Are terms used in which sport? A, badminton, B, volleyball, or C, water polo?
Badminton.
It's volleyball. Oh. The giant cock that was placed on the fourth plinth in Trafalgar Square
in
2013 was what colour? Red, white or blue?
Blue.
That's the correct answer! In what sport does Fanny Schmeller compete?
Oh, downhill skiing.
Because this went viral, didn't it?
It did, yeah. I'm taking that to my grave, which is very soon, I imagine. Yeah, I really am. Bless her, Fanny, yeah.
Please welcome Fanny Schmeller.
No!
I'm kidding.
Oh, no! You're joking.
No, I am joking.
Oh, well, right, okay. Oh, yeah, I thought she was
talking. Do you know where she's from?
Austria.
Well, we couldn't get Fanny to come from Austria.
Oh my God, if Fanny Schmeller had come in, that'd have been the end of it.
Please welcome Fanny Schmeller.
No! I am so sorry. I am so sorry. I didn't mean to laugh.
Fanny's very happy to see you. And she's also very insistent that her name is actually
Fanny Schmeller.
Schmeler. I know, Schmeler.
I thought it was going to sound better.
I can't. This is really surreal. This is a surreal moment of my life. I am properly sweating. I am actually sweating. It's so lovely to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Gosh, you've got a grip and a half on you, haven't you?
Because she doesn't like you, Bradley. She's been building up to this moment for a decade.
I cannot believe you're here.
So we're going to actually play a game with Fanny. We're going to play a game called Fanny's Funny Schmells. So, Fanny's bought her box, and in it she has funny schmells. And what you have to do is identify what the schmells that have come from Fanny are. Okay? Here is your first smell. Can you smell that?
Yeah, it's cheese.
That's exactly the right answer! Well done. Okay, what is the next schmell? It's quite schmelly. Everyone have a schmell on that.
Oh, God.
It's quite schmelly.
Oh, dear. Oh, no, that's a shock.
What do you think that one is?
Is it some sort of herring?
Oh, very close.
Is it like a sardine?
It's a sea bass.
Yeah.
Bradders, you can take off your blindfolds And what an absolute treat. The actual Fanny
Schmieler. I cannot believe you're here.
Who would have thought?
Like, ladies and gentlemen.
Midnight, you half naked. Me, way too dressed.
This is the weirdest thing, really.
It's Fanny Schmieler Schmieler!
I cannot believe that.
It is now time to reunite you with a mystery guest. To give you a clue as to who that might be, please welcome your beloved son, Barney.
Barnes, yeah.
Barnes. Right. Ooh.
Why are you dressed up like...
This is so stupid.
So when have you last seen what you've just seen?
What are you talking about? I've no idea.
OK, we're going to play some music.
Is it my wife?
No, no. They're both clues to the same person. The clue was Barney doing that with the water and that music.
No. You can't be. It's not Peter Noakes, is it?
Ladies and gentlemen,
it's not
please
Peter
welcome
Noakes.
Peter Noakes!
No, it's not Peter Noakes. Oh, Peter!
Peter married you and Donna.
He did.
And
yeah,
also, and that was the clue here,
yeah,
christened
me.
Oh, it's lovely to see you, Pete.
And you, bro. Yeah.
Well, it's amazing to see you. Thank you very much. Oh, it's a... Nice. Go on, Pete, have a cuddle. Very good. You are currently naked,
yes,
but for your chain,
yeah,
and the Sandman's pants.
Yes, I'm sorry, yeah.
But back in the day, you have worn various pieces of clothing, including a blue coat.
I was a blue coat at Pontins, yeah.
Blue coat.
Was a blue
well,
coat
I'd like to introduce another celebrated blue coat. Please welcome Brian Connolly.
No.
I'm here, love!
No! It's Brian Connolly!
Hello, mate.
How are you?
Good. We got here your original blue coat, and we want to see if it fits.
Bradders, you have 20 seconds to see if you can still button it up.
I cannot believe it. What are you doing?
Look at this. 1982, he's still got it.
Yeah. He just about tossed to me there.
That's it.
Look at that. I'm nearly
there. No, you haven't got
fat. You've got to do it up, Brad.
I'm nearly there.
Come on, love.
Come on, Brad.
We want a drum roll. For
yeah!
Fits like a glove. Look at that. Sweet dreams, love. See ya.
Brian Connolly, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so it's time for our team talk.
Okay.
Who better to give you this team talk?
Who?
Well, it's Big Sam Allardyce.
No, it's not.
I cannot believe it.
Thought you needed a bit of refreshing.
My God.
So Big Sam's here to play a game. I'm going to blow hair dryers into your face.
Okay.
And Big Sam is going to shout some of his very well-known quotes. At the end of the quote, I'm going to turn the dryers off, and then you have to say the quote back to Big Sam to show you're paying attention, Sam.
Oh, I always pay attention to Sam.
You better. First quote incoming.
As a football manager, I'm right up there with Pep, Klopp and Arteta.
As a football manager, I'm right up there with Pep, Klopp and Arteta.
Not a bad start! Ooh, looks like I need to get these blowers going a bit more. All right, next quote incoming.
Blackburn and Bolton not good enough anymore. I'm more suited to Inter Milan and Real Madrid.
Something about Milan and Real Madrid.
Close! But not quite. All right, here we go.
I can't get a top four club anymore because my name's not Aladicio, it's Allardyce.
I can't get a top four club anymore because my name's not Aladicio, it's Allardyce.
Come on!
That is my favourite quote, by the way.
It's Sam Allardyce, he talked! Woo!
Oh, Sam, it's so lovely to see you, mate.
Very, very good.
Great to see you, Sam.
Thank you very much. Good night.
Is that it? Is that it? What happened now? Hello?
What's that about?
Hello? That's mad.
So fun.
Oh my god.
Fred is.
Wow. I'll tell you what, to see Peter Noakes, my vicar, yeah. You know, wow, just he means a lot to me. So it's just lovely to see him.
It's an emotional roller coaster.
Oh, it was great, but I've got to say, that's one of the. I've been in this industry now, I got into show business in 1986, and to have that, I've done some wonderful things in my life, but to have that sort of prank played on you and to have all the people that you love, thank you so much for that.
Oh, Brent, it was an absolute
a lovely
pleasure.
Thing. Bradley, it was truly, truly
it's been
great.
Amazing. Before you go, I've got a few things. Hold on. You can't go away empty-handed. We have a Fanny Schmieler fanny pack.
Fanny.
So that's for you. And, of course, you cannot go away empty-handed without me giving you your iconic
midnight
game show.
Oh, that is so cool.
Do not disturb Simon to ensure this will never happen to you again.
Oh, thank you,
One
Michael.
More time for the absolutely sensational Bradley Walsh-Rossi. There you go, brothers.
Thank you.
For the Bradley! Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, now we have a treat for you. It is the Queen of British Soul. She's an Olivier Award-winning star of the West End, performing Everything's Gonna Be All Right from her brilliant album, The Fifth Chapter. It's the sensational Beverly Knight! Beverly Knight, ladies and gentlemen.
Whoa!
Everything's going to be all right.
I've never felt
it more. You look absolutely sensational. And the song is amazing.
Thank you so much. This is from
your new album.
It is.
And then you're going to be touring this?
I am. I am part two of my 50 tour. And I'll be in the West End a couple of months' time. I'll be there in Sister Act.
Well, it's amazing to see you. The wonderful ladies and gentlemen, Beverly Knight, what a treat for us all. Amazing. So, ladies and gentlemen, who would like to find out what replies Catherine Ryan has received in Send to All? Okay. So, let's remind everybody the text I sent into Catherine's phone earlier tonight. I've got a new stand-up routine about the first time we met and how weird you were. I use your name as the joke doesn't really work without it. I'm going on Graham Norton this week and really want to tell it. Just checking you're okay with that. Happy to pay you something. Bag of cash. Emoji.
It's the bag of cash that is extra offensive.
Okay. So, we will start with... Oh, Adam Hills Hillsy. Depends on how weird I was. No need to pay if I was just awkward. £100 if I was stupid. £200 if I was creepy. Any worse than creepy, I might need you to pay my legal bills. Come on, Hilsey! Sarah Pascoe has said, hey, that's good that you finally got on Graham Norton, hun. Not bad. Jonathan Dean, who's that?
Oh. His lovely wife, Rosmond, is a very talented journalist.
Right. That's his wife, though, because he's put, hello, I'm happy to have some money, but I'm 99% sure this was for somebody else because we've never actually met. I might text back. You just don't remember, weirdo.
That's how weird he was.
Now, there's been a lot of drama from Sean Walsh. He is really worried. He is a very panicky person. And quite honestly, this text has not helped. He started with WTF! Exclamation mark. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8 crying laughing emojis. Then another text, what is this? Then 5 question marks. Then another text, FFS. Then another text, I'm absolutely terrified. Then another text, oh God, what did I do? Then another text, it's so worrying that you're not replying. I'm so worried about Sean. And he's online, he's waiting. This is quite funny, because there's all these comedian bookers that we both know. So Math Brown has worked out that you're playing Send to All, and he's just said, hello, Michael, fancy coming down to Kingston soon? He's trying to book me for a gig. Who's Pam Beleaf?
Oh, that's my therapist.
Really, your therapist?
She's a great therapist.
Really?
It's bee leaf, like bee like buzz, and then a leaf in nature, but it's also bee leaf.
She started with That's 1, 2, 3, 4 M's. Full stop. How about you just pay the regular fee for our next session and we can talk through this high quality problem then?
She's great.
Kind regards. Oh. They have to keep it formal, the therapists.
Always kind regards from Pam.
Roberto Hare. He sounds amazing. By the way, I've just clicked on his photo. He looks exactly how you'd expect him to look. It's Roberto Hare. Roberto Hare. I presume he's a hairdresser called Roberto.
He is.
Hello there. Is he Italian? No. Does he sound
is
Italian?
From, what's not Brazil, but I always tell my mom it's Brazil. Where's Lisbon?
Argentina?
Portugal.
Portugal. Portugal. Hello there, how are you and the babies and Bobby and the doggies? Was I weird? Of course you can, I don't care. It's a little publicity.
Roberta.
P.S. Let me know when it's on and I can watch it. That was... I've just had word that Miles is here for the massage. Where is he? It's Miles! Here he is! Yeah, Miles! Yeah! Oh, Miles! Miles, sorry, it's a bit of a surprise, obviously. Don't panic. They're not going to be viewing you at work. 127 five-star reviews, Miles. What's your secret?
Just give a good massage, really.
Okay, well, I suppose I better send you up to the box, and we'll end this sensible with you getting to work on Catherine. Okay, we'll send Miles round to the box. Ladies and gentlemen, what an absolutely brilliant sensual that was. Go on, Miles, get to work! That's it. That's what all of our sensual victims need. The amazing Catherine Ryan, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so. Earlier tonight, we surprised Alfie when he thought he was here for an exclusive gaming experience. It's almost time for his performance, but let's have a look at how he's been getting on backstage since that enormous surprise.
Okay. Yeah, I'm really good. Oh my God, Frank.
You're brilliant.
Thank you.
You're brilliant.
That was absolutely amazing. It is a dream come true to have the opportunity to sing in front of 2,000 people. I just want everyone in my position to hopefully be inspired. And if I can do that to one person even, then I've done my bit to help. Singing means everything to me. With the cerebral palsy, there was limitations there, but singing has made me feel like I can do anything. It takes me to another place. The song means a lot because the words resonate with me. Singing makes me feel free.
Well, what an extraordinary young man here to sing us out tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, give all your love to the unexpected star of tonight's show. It's Alfie!
Stay.
ladies and gentlemen, the unexpected star of tonight's show, Alfie!
What a moment.
My dear boy. What a surprise, eh?
Bravo.
What a game's like. What a game's like. Oh, amazing. Wasn't that amazing, ladies and gentlemen? Yeah, I know that Anthony, your singing teacher, is super proud of you.
What can you say? I'm totally touched and moved by all the years we've spent with Alfie. What a beautiful...
When did you start working with him, then?
About 11 years ago.
Dedication! Absolutely. Dean,
yeah.
You're Alfie's mate. How did that feel?
It was amazing. He works so hard, and aww, everything he has to put through, he does smashes it every time. We go from playing FIFA in our room to going up to Chelsea, and now he's on a big stage, and he's just a big inspiration to me. He's like, he's just everything I've seen.
Mum, that must be very emotional.
Very, very emotional. Yeah. Alfie has struggled all his life, but he's never given in. I'm very proud of him, and I love you.
Well, you deserve this night. You've been amazing.
Thank you so much.
Just tell us, there's 2,500 people here. How does that feel, performing for all of them? And, of course, the millions who'll be watching at home.
Yeah, I think for me, like, with the song Born Free, with my cerebral palsy, you could say I wasn't necessarily born free, but this song gives me the ability to be free in my singing. And if there's anyone watching at home that thinks they can't achieve what they want to achieve in their life, I just want you to watch this and think about that. And you can be anything you want to be in this world.
Amazing. Amazing, 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 unexpected star of tonight's show. What a legend! Ladies and gentlemen, it's Alfie! Absolutely sensational. Thank you very much. Good night, Bravo!
Comedy Mayhem in the Classroom, Bad Education, starring Leighton Williams. Press rent to watch now on iPlayer. New Weakest Link here next on BBC One. Luba from Strictly is one of the famous faces trying to...
なれそうげれなきゃとき聞けないからもらこりさまたピカピカぜなかなのきかたらひらもりしねきまきさまれ
Fancy coming down to Kingston soon. He's trying to book me for a gig. Who's Pam Beleaf?
Oh, that's my therapist.
Is it really your therapist?
She's a great therapist.
Really?
It's Beleaf, like B like buzz, and then a leaf in nature, but it's also Beleaf.
She's got... Oh, she started with hmm. Wow. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 M's. Full stop. How about you just pay the regular fee for our next session and we can talk through this high-quality problem then?
She's great.
Kind regards. They have to keep it formal, the therapists.
Always kind regards from Pam.
Roberto Hare. He sounds amazing. By the way, I've just clicked on his photo. He looks exactly how you'd expect him to look. It's Roberto Hair. Roberto Hair. I presume he's a hairdresser called Roberto.
He is.
Hello there. Is he Italian? No. Does he sound Italian?
He is from, what's not Brazil, but I always tell my mom it's Brazil. Where's Lisbon?
Argentina?
Portugal.
Portugal. Portugal. Hello there, how are you and the babies and Bobby and the doggies? Was I weird? Of course you can. I don't care. It's a little publicity.
Roberto.
P.S. Let me know when it's on and I can watch it. Double T. I've just had word that Miles is here for the massage. Where